गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज फोर्स ऑन ए करेंट कैरिंग वायर प्लेस्ड इन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सी इन द ऑस्टर्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड दैट व्हेन अ वायर इज कैरिंग अ करेंट एंड अ मैग्नेटिक कंपास वॉज प्लेस्ड बिलो दैट वायर सो दैट मैग्नेटिक कंपास वॉज शोइंग द डिफ्लेक्शन. दैट मीन्स द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वॉज developed around the wire and the magnetic compass was experiencing a force in that field. Okay, so now here the new topic is the force on a current carrying wire. When a wire is carrying a current, so when that wire is placed in the magnetic field, it is experiencing a force. So the question arises, why that current carrying wire experiencing a force? For that, let us perform one activity. We will place the current carrying wire in a U-shaped magnet. Okay, this is the U-shaped magnet. Okay. N and S are the north pole and south pole of the magnet. So we will pass the current, means the wire magnet, U-shaped magnet is like this, and we will pass the current from in between. Okay. So here we will make certain arrangement to make the wire straight. Okay, with the help of a hanger, and we will connect with the terminals of the battery. Here the key is provided. So when we will start the experiment, we will close the circuit. Okay, then we will observe that the current will start flowing in this direction. And what we have observed some of the things, that this wire, horseshoe magnet, is like this. The wire is placed here, so the wire will experience a force in the outward direction. This we have observed experimentally, that the current carrying wire has experienced force in the outward direction. So force experienced by the wire was perpendicular to the magnetic field. See, the direction of magnetic field is from north to south direction. So the first thing we have noted, that the force experienced, means the motion of the wire, was perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so magnetic field lines start from the north pole and end towards the south pole. This we have studied. So the force experienced by the wire is directed away from the, or perpendicular, remember the other thing, it was perpendicular to the magnetic field. Why this current carrying wire was experiencing force? Why? My question is, why the current carrying wire was experiencing force? In the Oster experiment, we have studied that a current carrying wire produces a magnetic field. Here we have placed that current carrying wire in the external magnetic field. So the magnetic field produced by the current carrying wire and the external magnetic field, due to the interaction of both the magnetic field, the current carrying wire will experience force. Okay, understood? Current carrying wire is producing its own magnetic field. This U-shaped magnet, it has its own magnetic field. So this wire, current carrying wire, is placed in the external magnetic field. So due to the interaction of both the magnetic fields, the current carrying wire will experience force. Can you say that according to Newton's third law, as the magnet is exerting a force, the wire will also exert a force? So this can be, because as the current carrying wire is lighter, so that is why it is experiencing a force. Okay, so first thing we have noted, that the force experienced by the wire was perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. Second observation was that force experienced by the wire was perpendicular to the direction of the current. See, the current was flowing in this direction and the force was in perpendicular to the direction of the current carrying wire. So two things we have noted. First one is that force experienced by the wire was perpendicular to the magnetic field. Force experienced by the wire was perpendicular to the direction of the current flowing. So from here, what we have concluded that maximum force was exerted on the wire when it is perpendicular to the magnetic field and perpendicular to the direction of the current. When the wire was held parallel to the magnetic field, when the wire was held parallel to magnetic field, it is not experiencing any force. These were the three things we have observed from this activity, that when the current carrying wire was held parallel to the magnetic field, no force was exerted on the wire. So all these experimental conclusions led us to the Fleming's left hand rule, that how we will remember where the magnetic field is, external magnetic field, where the current is flowing, and where is the force experienced. So all these three things are given by Fleming. So Fleming said that if we will, here we have to use, this is known as the Fleming's left hand rule. So Fleming's left hand rule states that we will use the left hand. Here we will use our left hand. This finger is said to be the thumb finger, this is said to be the index finger, and this is said to be the middle finger. So here what we have observed, the force experienced was perpendicular to the magnetic field, force experienced was perpendicular to the current. Means all the three are mutually, force, magnetic field and current. From this activity only we have concluded that the force experienced, magnetic field and current, these are mutually perpendicular to each other. So what we have found that Fleming, he has invented a rule. He said that stretch your three fingers, thumb finger, index finger and middle finger, perpendicular to each other, such that this thumb will indicate the force, index finger will indicate the magnetic field, and this middle finger will indicate the direction of the current. Okay, we have to stretch the three fingers, thumb finger, index finger and middle finger, perpendicular to each other, such that thumb indicates the direction of the force or the motion, index finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, and the middle finger indicates the direction of the current. Okay, so let us apply over here. Force, magnetic field and current. The current is flowing in the downward direction. See, you have to place the your middle finger in the direction of the current, and this one index finger represents the direction of the magnetic field. So the force experienced was outwards, as I have said you in the experiment we have observed. So in this way we will apply the Fleming's left hand rule. But if the direction of the current was reversed, here if we reverse the direction of the current, what we will observe, that current will flow in this direction. Okay, and now see the deflection, force, magnetic field, current. So magnetic field in this direction, but the current is in the upward, so slowly you will twist your wrist and you will observe that the force, see this one is the magnetic field north to south, and this one, this one finger, middle finger is representing the direction of the current. So you will point the middle finger in the direction of the current. So you will observe that this thumb is going inside the board. So means it is also deflecting perpendicular to the direction of the current and direction of the magnetic field. Okay. So this is what the Fleming's left hand rule. Sometimes the concepts are used of the dot and cross. This is the dot, and sometimes the concept of cross is also used. So dot means the magnetic field lines are coming outwards. The magnetic field lines are, magnetic field lines are outward, okay? And here the magnetic field lines are inwards. If you have seen Mahabharata, in that arrows were used. See that arrow was in this shape. So if the arrow is coming outwards, so you will observe the tip of this arrow. And if this arrow is going inside, then you will observe the feathers of the arrow. So that is why the cross. So in this way, you will remember that magnetic field, if it is outwards, then you will represent through the dots. And if the magnetic field lines are going inside, then it is represented through the cross. Okay, thank you.